Hello, people of YouTube, and welcome back to Bigger Feet for this tutorial about creating a full CMYK half tone print effect in After Effects. I've seen quite a few tutorials approximating this effect, particularly quite a few that only do a monochrome version, and I've only seen one tutorial before that goes into doing the full color effect. That tutorial is by Ben Marriott. It's excellent and quite elegant, but in his tutorial you have to export every frame individually, then pass it through Photoshop, and then take it back into your video editing software. Which brings us to the tutorial we're doing here today. Everything you're gonna see happens within After Effects without third-party plugins, which gives you, in my humble opinion, a really rather convincing full color halftone print effect, and it stays flexible because it's all within After Effects. So, without further ado, this intro is a little bit too long, let's dive in. First, of course, you're going to create a composition of your size and frame rate of choice. I'm working in 1080p so that my computer doesn't explode while I'm recording this tutorial, but of course, working in 4K lets you retain a lot more detail, because we are about to lose a lot of detail working with large dots instead of itty bitty pixels. When you've created your composition, create a white solid as your background and lock it, because we don't need to touch it anymore. Then add your footage above that. I'm working with this clip of a boat ride where a dog definitely wanted to jump into our boat, but honestly you can use anything you like. This effect works particularly well on stylized graphics, for example, like this intro card, or this intro card, or these shoes. Something worth considering is that it works especially well on high contrast scenes, because the dots get smaller and smaller in brighter areas. If you have a scene that is bright across the board, you get a very dotty and potentially distracting end result. Our Bigger Feet intro card suffers a little bit from that. But on the other hand, this Vondelander intro card does not. Because it has a lot of dark areas, the dots there just blend into each other, creating black solids. And this makes the white logo and the snow on the mountaintops stand out. So that's just something worth considering when to use this effect. Bright foreground, dark background. Works excellently. Either way, once you've got your footage in place, you can go ahead and make it invisible. Then we select the ellipse tool, change the color to black, and make the ellipse. Now let's center it. Press Y to bring up the anchor point tool, and click and hold the anchor point. Hold down Alt and Control, and drag. Make sure you snap it so that the anchor point is in the middle. Then we open its parameters. Contents, ellipse 1, ellipse path 1. We're going to set the size to 1 by 1 pixel. Now we can turn this one dot into a grid. Open the Add menu within the circle's contents and select Repeater. Then open the repeater and its Transform section. Then we add the amount of dots we want. For a 1080p sequence with 10 pixel dot spacing, 240 dots is enough. Make sure you set the offset to minus half the amount of dots, in this case minus 120. In the Transform section, we set the distance between the dots. I'm going for 10 pixels horizontally, and for now, 0 vertically. Duplicate the repeater by clicking it and pressing Ctrl D. Then set the duplicate's position to 0 horizontal and 10 vertical. And there's your dot matrix, nice and evenly spaced. Of course, if you're working in 4K, you need to double the amount of dots and the offset, but leave the spacing at 10. Ultimately, we will have 3 layers of dots, so let's label them appropriately so we can keep them straight. I will label this one something like red response, cyan dots, and I'll set the color label to red. Now here comes the fun part. Add the camera lens blur effect and set your footage layer as the input blur map. Make it take into account effects and masks and respond to the red channel. That's why we called the layer red response. Also invert the blur map, set placement to stretch map to fit, set the blur map radius to 6, and make the iris 100% round. It's a little bit hard to see what's going on right now, so we're going to add the levels effect. Set the channel to alpha and make the input white 2. You should now have a pretty hard black and white dotted image. Anything with high red channel saturation will get big dots, anything with low red channel saturation in your footage will get small dots. It is a little bit messy right now though, so I'm going to give you 2 options to clean it up. For a cleaner look, we'll tack on the key cleaner effect. Set the edge radius to 2, turn on reduce chatter, and whack alpha contrast up to 100%. You can see that this gets rid of the tiniest dots in the highlights and firms up the bigger dots in the darks. Not to mention that it smooths out any artifacts. This effect, however, is really heavy to run, and in my case, it takes 10 times longer to render anything with this effect enabled. So for render time reasons, we are getting rid of that, adding the fast box blur effect, and setting the radius to 1 pixel. It's much lighter to run, but admittedly it doesn't clean up the highlights and lowlights quite as well, and it doesn't get rid of the artifacts. Let's just say this slightly more messy look feels more vintage or whatever. And move on. Now we need to set the color of the layer to cyan. Cyan is the inverse of red and it's equivalent in subtractive color processing. So we add the change to color effect, set black as the from color and cyan as the to color. Cyan's hex code is 00FFFF. Also pick hue, lightness and saturation from the drop-down menu. Excellent! That is the hardest work done. Now we just need to duplicate this layer twice and make magenta and yellow dots as well. So select the layer, press Ctrl-D to duplicate, and then press Ctrl-D to duplicate it again. Then set the labels to green response magenta dots for the first one, and blue response yellow dots for the second one. Let's first alter the green response layer, and just for clarity I'm making the other layers temporarily invisible. Then we go into the green response's camera lens blur effect and change the channel to green. Also change the change to color from cyan to magenta, because magenta is the inverse of green. The hex code for this is FF00FF. That is our response done, but as it is, the magenta and cyan dots occupy the same space. What we need to do is create a pattern that meshes the dots with each other, but doesn't have them obscure each other. So on top of all the green response layer's effects, we add the transform effect, and we set the rotation to -22.5 degrees. It's really important that this effect sits on top, because we only want to impact the rotation of the actual dots, but not the effects underneath. Now for the blue response layer. Same exact process. Change the blur mask channel to blue and set the color to yellow, because yellow is the inverse of blue. The hex code for this is FFFF00. Here we also add the transform effect at the very top, but this time with a +22.5 degree rotation. And now we are essentially done with our basic effect. Just make sure you make all of your dot layers visible and switch over to the blend modes. Then you can set the blend mode for all of these layers to multiply. Ta-da! A full color, half tone CMYK print effect. Now, some of you might be wondering why we didn't also create a matrix of black dots. Because in normal CMYK printing, you need a matrix of black dots to impart that deep, rich tone. That's what the K stands for, that's the black ink. Because just mixing cyan, magenta, and yellow inks would get you a sort of murky brown. However, because we are working digitally, we don't run into the limitations of paper and ink. Mixing cyan, yellow, and magenta with each other digitally does render perfect blacks. However, that's not to say that you can't add a black matrix if you wanted to. The process is identical to the previous dot layers. Just set your blur map response to luminance, delete the set to color effect, and rotate it to a 45 degree angle. Make sure that this layer sits on top and that you're using a milder blend mode, like soft light. This way our black dots impart a bit of depth without completely obscuring everything. That said, I do think the whole thing now looks a little bit crushed, so I'm going back to the original footage and add the levels effect and set the gamma to 1.2. The actual footage now looks really flat, but in our print emulation it just lifts the darks enough to reveal a bit of detail. And I think that's starting to look really lovely, and it's kind of up to you now how you want to sell the effect. A couple of things that will go a really long way are adding some film grain, a looping paper texture, and adding an adjustment layer at the top with the posterized time effect. I like to set it to 6 or 8 frames per second so you get that sort of slow flipbook vibe. Something that's also fun is adding the wiggle expression to all of your dot layers' position parameters. This way you get the sense that the printer alignment was slightly different for every single frame, which gives it more of an organic feeling. Do note though that shifting all of the dots independently has an effect on how they overlap and what colors they reproduce, meaning that every new frame now gets a slightly different color temperature and tint. I'll leave it up to you whether or not you like that effect. Like I said, I think it's quite cool. It feels a bit organic. And there you have it, a full color CMYK half tone printing effect done entirely within After Effects and without third-party plugins. If you're doing anything particularly cool with this effect, leave it in the comments below because we'd love to see your work and get inspired. Other than that, thank you very much for watching and don't forget to push some of the positive buttons down below, and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao!